This video is all about Azure Reserved Instances. Hello everyone, my name is Travis and this is Heraltos. Reserved Instances offer significant savings for IaaS servers, SQL Database, and Cosmos DB. I've mentioned Reserved Instances a couple times in other videos, one on saving money in Azure and once in Azure Cost Management. I'll have the links above someplace. I didn't get into details in those videos on how Reserved Instances work. So here are the details of Azure Reserved Instances. Before that, I've heard some people are watching these videos but have not subscribed, and that makes this kitten sad. You don't want a sad kitten, do you? Please subscribe. Think about the kittens. Moving on. Reserve instances allow you to prepay for 1 or 3 years of Azure services, including Cosmos DB capacity, SQL Database, vCore, and IaaS VMs. This does not include storage or data transfer costs. Reserve instances provide a 72% savings from pay-as-you-go. They are transferable and can be canceled for a small fee. I'll get into both of those items in a minute. This is a great option for qualifying services that you are committed to using for the foreseeable future. For example, I have a small IaaS server running as a domain controller in Azure. I'm going to purchase a reserve instance for that and save over $200 a year. Here's how it works. In exchange for committing to paying for 1 or 3 years of qualifying services, Microsoft will apply a discount to those services. The discount is applied based on the resource size and region. They are not applied to specific named instances, to a specific VM, for example. This is a use it or lose it model. If there's no service to apply the discount to at a given month, for example, the discount will be lost. Discounts are applied to a scope and will only be available to resources in that scope. A scope can be a resource group. This is the most restrictive. The reserved instance would only apply to qualifying services within that resource group. This would make sense for organizations that may charge back by resource groups. You wouldn't want a reserve instance HR paid for to be applied to marketing VMs. This is even more important for cloud service providers who separate and bill clients based on resource groups. Reserve instances can be applied to qualifying services in a subscription. This is less restrictive than the resource group. Shared scopes will apply to qualifying services for subscriptions in a billing context. A billing context could be all eligible subscriptions created by a single administrator for pay-as-you-go subscriptions, or all subscriptions in an enrollment for EA customers. The good news is the scope can be modified as long as they stay within the same billing context. So, for example, a reservation can be moved between subscriptions in an EA enrollment. I mentioned earlier that the reservation is not assigned to a specific VM. Reservations are applied to all matching services in the scope. Here you can see how adding a reservation to a shared scope will apply the discount to any eligible service within that scope. While applying the reservation to the subscription will apply to only the eligible services within that subscription, and likewise applying to the resource group is limited to the qualifying services within that resource group. Where it applies is dependent on your organization. If you charge back at the subscription or resource group, the benefit should probably be applied to that level for customers who paid for that reservation. Reserve instances have an option called instance size flexibility. This provides the ability to change the size of a service a reservation can be applied to. For example, let's say you purchase 2 reservations for a standard B4MS servers. You scope them to a resource group with 2 B4MS servers. Now let's say that things change and you no longer need 1 of the 2 B4MS servers. Instead, you need 2 smaller standard B2MS servers. With size flexibility, you can apply the B4MS reservation to 2 B2MS servers. Size flexibility uses the concept of ratios assigned to the server in the same size series group. A standard B8MS server has a ratio of 16. So that reservation could be applied to 2 B4MS servers, or 4 B2MS servers, or 16 B1MS servers. You could not, however, apply the standard B4MS reservation to 2 standard D2 servers because they are in a different size series group. Servers need to be in the same reservation scope and region for size flexibility. Let's walk through purchasing a reservation on my pay-as-you-go subscription and then go over some of that fine print that's always important when purchasing from Microsoft. Buckle up everyone, it's demo time. In this demo, I'm going to review reserved instances and then purchased a reserved instance for one of my servers. So we'll start out by going down to, let's see here, Azure Advisor. There it is. And here you can see it's giving me some recommendations. Right down here, along underneath security, high availability, and performance, it's giving me a cost recommendation. And this is saying I can save up to $267 a year. So what I'm going to do is come over to All Services and type in Reservation. Azure Advisor is a good spot to look to see different suggestions that Microsoft recommends to improve your subscription and your environment. But for this, I'm just going to stick with Reservations for now. And I'll go over to Reservations. And you can see I have no reservations, but it gives me the option to purchase one now. Here there's listed all of the different services where you can purchase reservations. Some of them are from Microsoft, some of them are from third parties. But if you use any of these and you plan on using them long term, it definitely would be a cost savings to purchase reserved instances. So I'm going to hop over here and just purchase the virtual machine. And here is my standard B2S, that's the server that I'm running. And I only see the 1 year version, but if I remove that filter, you can see I have 1 year and 3 year. I am gonna stick to a 1 year on this, but if I wanted to go 3 years, that's how I'd find it. And you can see the little icon here for Azure Advisor. That's telling me that this is a good one that I should do. So I'm gonna click on that. It's gonna calculate out. So if I purchase this for 1 year ahead of time, it's gonna cost me $256 US. Monthly, I spend $43 on this, which totals out to be about $516 a month. So spending the $256 now is certainly gonna save me a lot of money over the next 12 months. So let's go ahead and select that. Actually, let's just take a look at this. What happens if I pick the 3 year? So that would cost me $494 for a 3 year period. And considering it's $516 per year, that's a pretty good savings. But again, I'm not gonna commit 3 years to this. I'm just gonna go to the 1 year and I'll select that. And there it is. I could do multiple if I wanted to. Let's just take a look at this link. So this is interesting. This tells me that I can apply the reservation to these two B2S servers and then the B1S servers. And it gives me some details about instance flexibility. We talked about that and this will apply. This here says the capacity priority is only available with reservations on a single scope. Let's go back and take a look at that. Let's go back and purchase now. We'll get back to where we were just a second ago. You can see here the scope is set to shared. And here's where we can say single subscription or a single resource group. What happens if we go there? So here it's going to apply to a resource group. And here it is. This is my resource group. I don't want to do that. Let's just try subscriptions. I can apply this just to my subscription, not to the shared scope. And then I'll select that. And that's 1 year still. Same price. Now, if I click on instance size flexibility, I could also select capacity. I'm going to leave it to instance size flexibility and review and buy. We'll hit pay now and yes. So there we go. I'm going to pay an upfront fee for this at about half the price of the normal fee. And then I won't be charged for this server or for this size of server for the next 12 months. And that is going to apply directly to my credit card that I have on file for this pay-as-you-go subscription. Let's just give it a couple seconds to finish. All right, there, finished. That took about 2 or 3 minutes, something like that. And we're going to go over to browse reserved instances. And there it is. My virtual machine has succeeded and it expires on 7/13. That's pretty simple. So now this applies to, where did we say it applied to? I think I applied it to the subscription. Yep, single subscription. So we'll be able to get some details on utilization of this to make sure it's actually getting applied to a VM. Remember I said earlier that if you don't have a VM within that scope to apply the discount to, it's just use it or lose it. So this is a great way to keep an eye on that. All right, that's it for the demo. I hope you found it useful. Cool. There are some details that you should be aware of before moving into reserved instances. First, pricing varies between regions, and because of that, a reservation is bound to a region. For Azure VMs, the discount only applies to the infrastructure cost, not the OS. For Windows VM, you still have to pay the full OS price. This can be offset by using Azure Hybrid Benefits, if your organization qualifies. There is no way to move the reservation to a new region, but you can exchange the reservation for one of equal or greater value. This will create a new reservation, not carry over the existing one, so that start date resets. You can also cancel a reservation if you're not going to use it. There's a 12% fee applied to the cancellation, but obviously you don't want to purchase a reservation instance with plans of canceling. Despite the limitations, if you plan to use these services long-term, you will only pay less with reserve instances. I hope you found this helpful, and always remember, if you don't know where you're going, you might end up someplace else. Please subscribe, and thanks for watching.